from the beautiful Lakeland Civic Center in the citrus capital of the world, Lakeland, Florida, the pageant that will bring us the very first Miss Teen USA. Gentlemen from each of the 50 states in the District of Columbia, the lovely candidates for Miss Teen USA 1983.
Tonight we're greeting you for the first time. We're saying hello, greeting you for the first time. We've had lots of fun in the Florida sun, but now there's work to be done. So there's a crown to be won for the first time. The very first time.
Dance by television's exciting solid gold dancers. And from the top of the world record chart, the very special sound of Air Supply. From the Smash TV series Dallas, our hostess, the lovely Morgan Brittany. Television star and our host this evening, Michael Young. And from right here in Lakeland, Florida, the 75-piece Lakeland High School Marching Band. And the Florida Southern College Men's Ensemble.
Scope presents The Way It Was.
Mom, mouthwash tastes like medicine.
If it didn't, it wouldn't work.
Henry believed it. Today, he still does.
Henry, try Minty Scope. Tastes good.
Then it doesn't work.
Scope works. Don't let the good taste fool you. Try.
For me?
Mmm, Minty.
Fresh breath that lasts. Mmm, and you did it all for me.
Scope works. Don't let the good taste fool you.
Come on, guys, shake a leg.
I can't. These cords are too stiff, Dad.
No socks?
They don't feel good. Do I have to?
I give up. I've tried lots of softeners, even the liquids.
Not that new Downy.
You really think it's that much better than the others?
New Advanced Formula Downy out-softens all other fabric softeners, even other liquids. No other brand can touch new Downy softness.
You sure these are my cords?
Mm-hmm.
They're so soft. feels soft.
New Downy softens best.
And smells good.
Fresh.
April fresher than ever.
Thanks, Mom.
See? They love it.
Come on, guys.
New Advanced Formula Downy. The softness no other brand can touch.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host for this evening, Michael Young. Thank you. Thank you very much, and welcome to the world premiere of the Miss Teen USA pageant from the beautiful and ultra-modern Civic Center here in Lakeland, Florida. We're glad to be here. You know, each of our contestants is a winner of her individual state pageant, and each will be wearing a costume of her own choice, identified with her home state. And our winner will receive more than $100,000 in prize money and merchandise. You bet. Now, it's fitting that our young ladies, who have grown up in the age of the computer, will have their judges' votes entered and tabulated by a computer. You at home will, of course, be judging right along with our panel, I'm sure. So why not grab a pencil and a piece of paper and keep track of your own selections, okay? Also, by the way, if our winner tonight meets the age requirements, she will be the 52nd entrant in the Miss USA pageant to be held next May. Therefore, it's conceivable that our winner tonight could become Miss Teen USA, then Miss USA, and then finally go on to become Miss Universe. Three lifetimes worth of honors, all in one year. It's time to meet the stars of our show, our candidates in the Miss Teen USA Parade of States. State by state. First, the young lady from Alabama.
Hello, I'm Jerenae Johnson from Orly, Alabama.
Alaska.
Good evening, everyone. I am Linda K. Figgis from Fairbanks, Alaska.
Arizona.
Hello, my name is Chris Klein from Scottsdale, Arizona.
Voted Miss Amity, Arkansas.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Angie Boyd from Manila, Arkansas.
California.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sean Gardner from Modesto, California.
Colorado.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Julie Meyer from Brighton, Colorado.
Connecticut.
Hi, I'm Beth Baldwin, and I'm from Fairfield, Connecticut.
Delaware.
Hi, I'm Laura Enns, and I'm from Wilmington, Delaware.
District of Columbia.
Hi, I'm Patricia Custis, and I'm from Woodbridge, District of Columbia.
Florida.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Lauren from Winter Park, Florida.
Georgia.
Hello, my name is Kaylee Gerald, and I'm from Perry, Georgia.
Hawaii.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Erica Match from Honolulu, Hawaii.
Idaho.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Tammy Hamilton from Nampa, Idaho.
Voted Miss Photogenic, Illinois.
Hello, everyone. I'm Linda Burkholder from Lansing, Illinois.
Indiana.
Good evening. I'm Julie James from Warsaw, Indiana.
Iowa.
Hello, my name is Kim Heck, and I'm from Des Moines, Iowa.
Kansas.
Hi, I'm Melissa Lysak from Russell, Kansas.
Kentucky.
Hello, everyone. I'm Krista Keith from Medford, Kentucky.
Louisiana.
Hello, everyone. I'm Bale Cavalier of Houma, Louisiana.
Maine.
Hi, my name is Dina Duval, and I'm from Auburn, Maine.
Maryland.
Good evening. I'm Carla Kemp from Clinton, Maryland.
Voted the best state costume, Massachusetts.
Good evening. I'm Christine Lawler from Chelsea, Massachusetts.
Michigan.
Hi, I'm Cass McBride from Farmington Hills, Michigan.
Minnesota.
Hello, my name is Kimberly Ann S., and I'm from Shakopee, Minnesota.
Mississippi.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Teresa Zucconi from Leland, Mississippi.
Missouri.
Hi, I'm Lisa Logan from Columbia, Missouri.
Montana.
Hi, I'm Leslie Lucas from Miles City, Montana.
Nebraska.
Hi, I'm Jackie Keating from Lincoln, Nebraska.
Nevada.
Cannon from Las Vegas, Nevada.
New Hampshire.
Good evening. My name is Maureen Murray, and I'm from Merrimack, New Hampshire.
New Jersey.
Good evening. I'm Sherry Drummond, and I'm from Lake Hiawatha, New Jersey.
New Mexico.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Eloisa Cerna,
Idaho.
New York.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ruth Zakarian, and I'm from Amsterdam, New York.
North Carolina.
Good evening. My name is Janet Freeman, and I'm from Asheville, North Carolina.
North Dakota.
Hello, I'm Lisa Rubin from Grand Forks, North Dakota.
Ohio.
Hello, I'm Jamie Cleary from Martin Spear, Ohio.
Oklahoma.
Good evening. I'm Lorna Webb from Ada, Oklahoma.
Oregon.
Hello, I'm Gretchen Chama from Gresham, Oregon.
Pennsylvania.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Diane Hoyes from Washington, Pennsylvania.
Rhode Island.
Hi, everyone. I'm Melissa Sciarra from Warwick, Rhode Island.
South Carolina.
Hello, everyone. I'm Beth Woodard from Aiken, South Carolina.
South Dakota.
Good evening. I'm Karen Diane Hernis from Pierpont, South Dakota.
Tennessee.
Hello, I'm Shrey Dotson from Waverly, Tennessee.
Texas.
Hello, my name's Sherry Schultz, and I'm from Lubbock, Texas.
Utah.
Hello, everyone. I'm Natalie DeGroff from Farmington, Utah.
Vermont.
Hi, I'm Cindy Gentile from Charlotte, Vermont.
Virginia.
Hello, my name is Tina Morocco, and I'm from McLean, Virginia.
Washington.
Good evening, I'm Rhonda Monroe from Linwood, Washington.
West Virginia.
Hello, my name is Kay Skadden, I'm from Newell, West Virginia.
Wisconsin.
Hi, everyone, I'm Jane Zuata from Niagara, Wisconsin.
Wyoming.
Hello, everyone, I'm Shanna Thompson from Casper, Wyoming.
And those are the 51 candidates for the title of Miss Teen USA 1983.
Lovely. Hi. Dallas, I'm Catherine Wentworth. But here in Lakeland, Florida, I'm Morgan Brittany. And I'm delighted to be your hostess for this, the first Miss Teen USA pageant. Throughout the evening, I'll be taking you to various spots backstage and around the auditorium. Right now, I'm at my computer readout station. Our judges will make the official decisions and will register their scores for each contestant on computer terminals like this one. Our main computer will then average the judges' scores for each girl, and those results will be shown on your screen. Now, nobody here in the Civic Center tonight will see those scores. They're strictly for you, the television audience. We'll learn who our 10 semifinalists are after we take a tour of the Lakeland area with all 51 candidates in a special swimsuit segment, following this word from Head and Shoulders.
We're about to bring you a special fashion segment with our young ladies enjoying their new Sunset Beach swimsuits by Catalina. Now, the preliminary swimsuit competition was held right here on this stage with each young woman wearing a suit of the same design. The scores you're going to see during this segment are the ones given each girl during that competition. Now, there are many spots of scenic beauty in the Lakeland area, and much of the natural setting has to do with water. There are many lakes, of course, and to the delight of boat enthusiasts, many canals connecting those lakes. The beauty of the Lakeland area provides us with some wonderful settings for a swimwear fashion fun tour with our 51 contestants. At the Casa Loma complex on Scott Lake, there were a variety of activities, including water skiing, swimming, and everyone's favorite, just relaxing by the pool. Which is where we found a couple of young ladies wearing the latest in one-piece tank suits. Shanna K. Thompson of Wyoming and Miss Colorado Julie Evelyn Meyer. A game of Scrabble helps pass the time between swims for Natalie DeGraw of Utah and Cherie Dotson, who's Miss Tennessee. Now, the side of the swimming pool is the sunning spot chosen by Patricia Custis of the District of Columbia and Sherry Schultz, Miss Texas. Before moving on, we meet a couple of young ladies whose swimsuits show how the popular bold graphic designs are in this year, Nevada's Kim Cannon and Sean Gardner of California. Our fashion show moves to Fort DeSoto Beach, where the birds join us for some bird's eye views of another group of contestants. Now, this threesome trying unsuccessfully to net some small fish is made up of North Dakota's Lisa Rubin, Kathy McBride, Miss Michigan, and Laura Teresa Zapponi, who's from Mississippi. If you like clam chowder, you have to like it even more knowing that the clams were dug by two lovely ladies like Lisa Logan from Missouri and Delaware's Laura Michelle Inslin. Our cast of candidates includes this casting fisherwoman. Wearing a suit of flattering mitered stripes, it's Kentucky's Krista Kallane Keefe. The volleyball game is fun for the spectators, but it can be a little bit tiring for some of the players. The one we see here stopping for a rest and a glass of you-know-what is Miss New York, Ruth Elizabeth Zakarian, as she joins North Carolina's Janet Freeman. Two more watchers are a pair of Dixie Lovelies, Miss South Carolina, Beth Woodard, and Kelly Jarrells, who's from Georgia. It looks like this candidate is getting her exercise cheering on her friends on the volleyball court. She's South Dakota's Karen Diane Hernis. Now this is really living. You ride along the beach among the sea oats and the double-crested cormorants on an all-terrain cycle and have a chauffeur to boot. Now who lives that good? Arizona's Chris Keim, for one. Now as her chauffeur drives off, we're joined by a young lady who wants to get in some bird watching. Are they scissor-tailed flycatchers? Nope, they're herons, and certainly worth a 6,000-mile trip for Hawaii's Erica Mattich. Occasionally, you run into a cart with a problem, which seems to have happened to Pennsylvania's Diane Hoyes. And showing us this year's popular textured fabric suits are Miss New Hampshire, Maureen Ann Murray, and Tina Morocco, who's Miss Virginia. We're heading for the famous Cypress Gardens now, where this beautiful gazebo scene provides a background for still another sport for our young ladies. Yep, canoeing. Over the years, this has been a popular spot for weddings in this area. The pretty picture is made even prettier when we see some more contestants. The first is Vale Cavalier, who is Miss Louisiana. And here, paddling her own canoe, is Miss Arkansas, Angela Boyd. Now, canoeing was once a way of life for the Eskimos and Indians who lived in the home states of Alaska's Linda K. Ficus and Leslie Lucas, Miss Montana. Now, what more fitting cargo for a canoe than a picnic basket, like this one being delivered by Rhode Island's Melissa Sciarra to West Virginia's Kay Scadden, who passes it along to Tammy Hamilton, Miss Idaho, until finally it reaches and is opened by Beth Waldron, who happens to be the apple of Connecticut's eye. At the Imperial Lakes Country Club pool in Imperial Lakes, some young ladies from the Midwest tossed a beach ball around, from Indiana's Julie James to Miss Wisconsin, Jane Zawada, and on then to Kimberly Lane Heck from Iowa. An appreciative audience for one of our divers is made up of contestants who live a continent apart, Alabama's Jill Renee Johnson and Rhonda Monroe, Miss Washington. Coming prettily out of the pool in her white-trimmed wrap suit is Minnesota's Kimberly S. And perched alertly on the lifeguard chair is Linda Burkhalter from Illinois. From the opposite end of our country's east coast comes Miss Maine, Dina Duval. Now, you don't dive wearing sunglasses, as Oregon's Gretchen Lynn Toma remembers, just before she and Miss Ohio, Jamie Kolarik, in her Bando Mayo swimsuit, get set to take the scenic route to the pool. Ready, set, go, ladies. Ah, now come on, doesn't that look refreshing? Now these are the waters of Lake Hollinsworth, where a group of our contestants combine their fashion parade with still another favorite activity in the area, sailboating. At the Lakeland Yacht Club, they really got into it, not merely as passengers, but doing the chores too. Here are two returning sailors, Christine Lawler from Massachusetts, and Miss Marilyn Carla Kemp. From the Garden State to the Sunshine State has come Sherry Drummond, who is Miss New Jersey. Hoisting the sail like a real seafarer is Miss Nebraska, who is Jackie Kuning. Now the entire crew of this boat consists of Oklahoma's Lorna Webb and our home state representative, Florida's Laura K. Erdman. Keeping things shipshape is what this contestant is doing. She's Miss Vermont, Cindy Gentile. And finally, we see the bold stripes and wet look swimsuits of Miss Kansas, Melissa Lysak. And last but not least, Eloisa Maria Serna from New Mexico. And now it's through the sails and across the water to the Lud M. Spivey Fine Arts and Humanities Complex on the campus of Florida Southern College. Now, much of this beautiful campus was designed by distinguished architect Frank Lloyd Wright. And it's from there that we get a truly national greeting from our 51 Miss Teen USA candidates. And now our 51 young ladies in their Vicki Vaughn dresses are on stage with me. And they're on stage to learn which one of them our judges have chosen to be our 10 semi-finalists. Now, I admit to being impressed with the amount of effort that our judges have extended over the past week. Aware of the importance of their decisions, they have observed each contestant in our three areas of judging. One is the swimsuit competition, which I mentioned earlier. Also, there was an evening gown judging to be held. And of course, each candidate was interviewed separately by each judge. Now, the score for these events went into our computer for averaging, and now I'm about to read the results. I remind you that the names will be called in no particular order. And as I announce each semifinalist, you will see her composite preliminary score on your screen. Okay, good luck to all of you. Our first semifinalist is Miss Kentucky. Our second semifinalist is from the West Coast, Miss California. Our third semifinalist is Miss Arkansas. Our fourth semifinalist is from the state of New York. Taking us halfway there is another Southern Belle, Miss Texas. Sixth semifinalist is Miss Washington. Semifinalist is a lucky girl from the state of Nevada. Three more girls with a chance to be Miss Teen USA, and one of them is Miss Virginia. Our ninth semifinalist is Miss Pennsylvania. Oh. one more girl with a chance of having the honor of being the first Miss Teen USA, and she's from the state of Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, the Miss Teen USA semifinalists. Congratulations to you all.
Semi-finalists, let me tell you a little about each of the 10 young women who've moved one step closer to being Miss Teen USA 1983. We know now who the 10 semi-finalists are, and with the help of these cards, I'll tell you something about them. First, from Kentucky, the Commonwealth of Kentucky, comes Krista Kalane Keith. She's a high school sophomore who enjoys singing gospel music at civic functions and on cable television. Angela Boyd calls Manila, Arkansas home. She's a recent high school graduate and will attend Arkansas State University in the fall. From the land of JR and the Dallas Cowboys comes Sherry Schultz of Lubbock, Texas. Sherry is a high school senior. Kim Cannon hails from Las Vegas, Nevada. An honor student and recent high school graduate, Kim plans to begin college this fall. Also a recent high school graduate, Diane Hoyes is our contestant from Pennsylvania. An avid sports fan, Diane enjoys swimming, skiing, and playing pool. The Peach State, Georgia sends us Kelly Jurl. Aspiring to a career in entertainment, Kelly recently had the honor of performing for the governor's inauguration in Atlanta. Representing the state of Virginia is Tina Morocco. A cheerleader and athlete, Tina is a high school medalist in track and field. Rhonda Monroe is a native of Linwood, Washington. She's a high school senior and a model. Ruth Elizabeth Zakarian represents the state of New York. She's a recent high school graduate who enjoys modeling and performing with an improvisational theater group in her community. And from Modesto, California, that's home for 17-year-old Sean Gardner. She's a high school junior, and she works part-time as a modeling instructor. And those are our 10 semifinalists for Miss Teen USA. If you've been sharing the voting with our judges, how did you do? The next step is picking our 5 finalists. And you at home will see and hear everything upon which our judges will base their decisions. When we come back, we'll see how well our semifinalists respond to interview questions, all live and unrehearsed. From Lakeland, Florida, the Miss Teen USA pageant continues. After these words, from CAMA.
Our semifinalists to tell us something we should know about them, because now it's time for the Miss Teen USA interview competition. Now remember, after each interview, the home audience will see the score that our judges have given each one of the girls. We will begin the interviews by talking with Miss Kentucky. Miss Kentucky is Krista Kalane Keith. She's 15 years old. She's from Edgewood, and she's a sophomore in high school. Now, Krista, I understand you sang on cable television, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Now, do you plan to make singing a career?
Yes, I'd like to be a contemporary gospel singer.
A contemporary gospel singer. Now, what's a contemporary gospel singer?
Well, have you ever heard of Amy Grant?
Okay. She's a contemporary gospel singer.
Yes.
All right. How did you happen to get interested in gospel instead of, say, pop or rock or something like that?
Well, my father's a minister.
I see. Now, I've always heard that it's real tough being a minister's kid, is it?
No, I've always found a lot of benefits.
What are some of those benefits?
Well, good advice free.
Could all use a little bit of that. Thank you very much, Miss Kentucky. All right. Miss California. All right, Miss California is Sean Gardner. She's 17 years old. She's a high school junior from Modesto, California, right?
Right.
Now, everybody has the idea that California is Hollywood, glitter and glamour, but it's not the truth, is it?
No, not all. I'm from Modesto, and it's the heart of the San Joaquin Valley. And in our valley, we're known as the salad bowl country of America. We grow 6 crops of lettuce, radishes, onions, tomatoes. We're agriculture area.
So it's not like the pavements and the buildings of Los Angeles?
No. We also grow more cotton in our valley than any other country in our nation.
I'll be darned. Well, now, I also understand that you work in a modeling agency and you teach modeling to little kids.
Yes, I do.
How old?
Well, 3 to 12, and I just teach them a little bit about self-confidence and how to present yourself and walk and turn, just things like that.
Is there a lot of work for 3-year-olds?
No, not modeling, but it's good for them, you know. They feel better about themselves when they go to the school.
I think it's very admirable of you. Miss California. Thank you. Our third candidate is Miss Arkansas, and she's Angela Boyd. She's 18 years old and a recent high school graduate, plans to attend Arkansas State University in the fall. Now, you were also the winner of Miss Amity, right?
Yes, I was.
I remember the look on your face when you found out. How did you feel at that moment?
I was so excited. I was fainted.
Now, you're going to begin college this fall, right? What are you going to major in?
I'm going to major in fashion merchandising.
And what do you plan to do after you get your degree?
I hope to own my own fashion boutique.
Now, what kind of things would you sell in your fashion boutique?
Mostly cocktail dresses and formals.
Now, tell us about the chaperones. I understand that when all the girls are down here, you have a chaperone, right? What do they do for you?
The chaperones buy you just anything you need. And my chaperone is one of the greatest. Her name is Ellen, and she's so sweet. We've made her a banner, Miss Ellen.
I understand that over the past week, something special happened to Miss Ellen, right?
Yes, she had her 70th birthday, and we celebrated it with a cake.
How did Miss Ellen manage to keep up with all of you?
She has managed very well. She stayed right behind us all the way.
Well, I think that's terrific. Thank you, Miss Arkansas.
Thank you.
Next, let's meet Miss New York. She's Ruth Elizabeth Zakarian. She's 17 years old. She's from Amsterdam, New York, and she's a recent high school graduate. Now, you've gotten out of high school. What do you plan to do now, Ruth?
Well, actually, I'm graduating under the early admittance program, so I will be finishing my last year of high school and my first year of college in the same year.
I see. And then what do you plan to do? You also are interested in theater, acting, I understand?
Yes. Then I'd like to transfer to the Herbert Berghoff School of Theatrical Arts in New York.
Now, I understand you were already involved in a theatrical group in your neighborhood.
Well, actually, I'm involved in a couple, Mike.
All right. Tell me about one of them.
One is the Role Players Repertory Company, and that's one of the ones I really enjoy a lot. We do improvisational acting.
Now, what kind of improvisational acting do you do?
Well, say, for instance, maybe a school would ask us to come and do a skit for them on maybe drug abuse. And then we would have a situation and then make up the lines as we go along. We present problems, but we do not present answers because life doesn't have answers to all the problems.
You're just trying to help kids bring out their feelings.
Yes, well, it helps them to think, to make up their mind about things.
Thank you very much, Miss New York. And now we have Miss Texas. Her name is Sherry Schultz. She's 17 years old and from Lubbock, Texas, and she's a high school senior. So you're going to be getting out soon, right?
I hope so.
Hope you do, too. What are your plans for the future, Sherry?
Well, after high school, I hope to go to college at Southern Methodist University in Dallas, Texas, and I hope to pursue a career in broadcasting.
Do you want to work in front of the camera, behind the scenes, what?
Well, I want to work both. I want to work behind the cameras with the lightings and the technical problems, as well as in front of the camera as a model.
I think she should work in front of the camera, don't you? Yeah.
Thank you.
Now, you've come to Lakeland, and you've been here all this week with girls from all over the country. You're the candidate, first Miss Teen candidate from Texas. What do they ask you about Texas?
Well, ironically, they ask me how many horses I have in my backyard, how many oil wells we have in Texas, and do I know JR personally? But I guess now I can tell them no, but I know Morgan Brittany.
Yes. Morgan will arrange for a personal introduction, I'm sure. Thank you very much, Miss Texas. Ladies and gentlemen, those are our first five semifinalists for the Miss Teen USA 1983. Now, we'll meet the next five in just a minute, but before we do, I think I see this tiny little figure way up there on the balcony, and it looks an awful lot like Morgan, and it is Morgan.
Hi, Michael. And while Michael is checking his notes and getting ready to interview our second five semifinalists, I thought you'd like to join me up here for a moment. You know, this is as close to a bird's eye view as you'll get without actually sprouting wings. We'll meet our second five semifinalists in just a minute. But now here's a word from Pringles.
Time to put the tail on the donkey!
It's time now to talk with our second group of semi-finalists in our Miss Teen USA interview competition. So, please come forward, Miss Washington. Miss Washington is Rhonda Monroe. She's 17 years old, and she's a high school senior. Hi, Rhonda.
Hi.
What do you plan to do when you graduate from high school?
I'm going to go to college and take business and fashion design and fashion merchandise.
And then what do you eventually want to have, a boutique or something, or what?
No, I just want to go to school so I have something to back me up.
I see. What is your then major career goal then?
To be a professional model.
Now, you've already done a good bit of modeling, correct?
Yes.
What would you say? I'm sure there are lots of girls out there who are watching who are younger and want to get into modeling. What would you tell them? What kind of advice would you give them?
If they want to do it, do it. You should do everything you want to do in life. You only live once.
Is it hard work, though?
It's hard, but it's worth it. It's lots of fun. You meet a lot of beautiful people.
I understand you had an opportunity to travel to Japan in your modeling, right?
I was in Japan last year at this time.
Did you learn any Japanese?
A little.
Say something for us.
Oh. Domo arigato. Thank you.
That's what?
Thank you.
Oh, and thank you, Ms. Washington. Thank you very much. Next, we have Miss Nevada. She's Kim Cannon. She's 18 years old from Las Vegas, Nevada, and she's a recent high school graduate. Hi, Kim.
Hi.
What are your plans for the future?
No, I don't live in a hotel. I live in a house.
And what else did they ask you?
Well, they asked me what it was like living there, if I gambled, if I went on the strip. But
do you gamble?
No, you have to be 21 to gamble.
Okay, good. Of course, it's a normal life, only she has a slot machine in the hallway, right?
Right.
Thank you, Miss Nevada.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Next, we have Miss Virginia. Miss Virginia is Tina Morocco. She's 16 years old. She's a high school senior and attends Bishop O'Connell High School. I know Bishop O'Connell High School. Do you have a good football team this year?
I sure hope so.
Now, you're also a cheerleader there, right?
Yes, I am.
So you'll be rooting them on.
For sure.
I understand they've already started school, if I remember correctly, right?
No, we don't start until next Tuesday.
Ah, so you have a little extra time, right?
A little.
Now, when you graduate, do you plan to attend college?
Yes, I do, and major in dentistry to become an orthodontist.
You're going to be an orthodontist. Why did you decide to be a dentist?
Well, I like to smile, and I like to see other people smile, and anything I can do to improve their smile, why not?
I think it's admirable. What did you learn about Lakeland, Florida over the last couple of weeks?
Well, I've learned that it is the citrus capital of the world, and in Polk County itself, it produces...
You can't go wrong, you're just right.
I learned that Polk County produces more citrus fruit than the whole state of California.
You're going to get me in trouble in a minute, huh? And you must have learned the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are going all the way, right?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Miss Virginia.
Thank you.
All right. Next, we have Miss Pennsylvania. She's Diane Hoyes, and she's 18 years old and a recent high school graduate. You've graduated now, so what are your plans for the future, Diane?
I'm going to go to school for fashion merchandising at the Fashion Institute of Design and Merchandising in Los Angeles, California.
Gonna cross the country?
Mm-hmm.
Will you feel a little bit frightened going to a state where you don't know anybody?
No, my two brothers live in there. They live in North Hollywood.
Oh, that's right. It says here your two brothers are actors.
Yes, they are.
You didn't want to be an actress?
Someday I would like to be an actress.
Oh, I see. You're going to start with fashion merchandising and then move on.
Right, right.
Now, I also understand that you're the editor of, you're the entertainment editor, rather, of your high school newspaper, right?
Mm-hmm,
what do you do as the entertainment editor?
We reviewed restaurants and concerts and put in gossip columns.
Could you like review Air Supply, who's going to be on our show soon?
Sure.
What would you say about Air Supply?
Give them an A+.
An A+. I think they give you an A+ too, Miss Pennsylvania. Thank you. And last, but certainly not least, we have Miss Georgia. Miss Georgia is Kelly Jarrells. She's 16 years old, and she's a high school senior. A senior. So what do you plan to do after graduation, Kelly?
First of all, I'd like to go to college at the University of Georgia.
Go Dogs, right?
Right. And I'd like to hopefully get a degree in early childhood education because I love children. And hopefully someday, hopefully, I'll be a singer.
Now, I understand you had an opportunity to sing at the governor's inauguration in Georgia, right?
Oh, yes. That was a very, very fun experience for me.
What was it like? Was it very exciting?
Oh, it was. I didn't sing at the gala because that's strictly professional, and I'm still strictly amateur. And I got to sing on the steps of the Capitol that day, and people were taking tours, and they stopped and listened, and it was really fun.
I also understand that you had an opportunity to eat dinner at the governor's mansion.
Oh, yes. I got to, me and two other people, one of my very good friends from Perry, Georgia, invited me to go spend the night at the governor's mansion, and it was wonderful, and it was so exciting because the butlers and everything, they served us food, and it was so nerve-wracking because I had to make sure everything was just perfect.
Well, at least we know the governor of Georgia is living well. I'll call the Reagans and see that they invite you as well, all right?
Okay, that'll be great.
Yes, thank you, Miss Georgia. And those are our 10 semifinalists, and one of them will be the first Miss Teen USA.
Well, we're waiting for the tabulated results of the judges' votes on the interviews. I'm glad I don't have to make a choice. Well, here are the scores. Miss New York was first, Miss Virginia was second, and Miss Georgia came in third. The swimsuit and evening gown competition live are coming up. But first, a word from Shure.
Raise your hand.
You got it.
Raise your hand.
I know just how to whisper, and I know just how to cry. I know just where to find the answers, and I know just how to lie. I know just how to fake it, and I know just how to scheme. I know just when to face the truth, and then I know just when to dream. And I know just where to touch you, and I know just what to prove.
10 semifinalists appropriately wearing their citrus orange swimsuits by Catalina. In our Miss Teen USA swimsuit competition. Now, when the judges enter their scores in this competition, the computer will average the scores and show the results to you, our home audience. Now, in a nautical setting reminiscent of the yachting and sailing spirit of Lakeland, Solid Gold Dancers set the stage for the Miss Teen USA semifinalists.
She attends Dixie Heights High School, where she's active in pep club and student council. Krista's plans for the future include a college degree in music and a career as a gospel singer.
Miss California.
Sean and her family enjoy spending their weekends together camping. She's not teaching modeling. She can be found swimming, dancing, or working out aerobic style. Sean is 17 years old, and she's a blue-eyed blonde.
Miss Arkansas.
Angela has blue eyes and blonde hair. A sports enthusiast, she enjoys jogging, gymnastics, and teaching cheerleading. Angela's goal for the future? A career in the world of fashion.
Miss New York.
Ruth begins college this fall, majoring in theater. Already, she's active in community theater and hopes to make acting her life's work. In her free time, Ruth enjoys karate, singing, and working with handicapped children. Ruth is 17 years old with brown eyes and black hair.
Miss Texas.
Blue-eyed blonde from Lubbock, Texas. She's a high school senior, and her plans for the future include a college education and a career in broadcasting. Sherry is a cheerleader, and she also enjoys tennis, skiing, and traveling with her family.
Miss Washington.
Rhonda has dark blonde hair and brown eyes. Back home, she enjoys a wide range of hobbies, including racquetball and cooking. Is she a good cook? The unanimous answer from her three brothers is, you betcha.
Miss Nevada.
18-year-old Kim has dark brown hair and blue eyes. She now calls Las Vegas home, but growing up, her family spent 2 years in Australia. She's a high school graduate and would like a career in computer science someday.
Miss Virginia.
Tina is a high school senior and hopes to become an orthodontist someday. A cheerleader and sports enthusiast, she has won numerous awards in track and field. She has green eyes, blonde hair, and is 16 years old.
Miss Pennsylvania.
Diane is 18 years old with green eyes and blonde hair. In her leisure time, Diane keeps active, swimming and skiing. Someday she hopes to have her own clothing boutiques in New York, Beverly Hills and Paris. Now that's style. Summers enjoying water sports, but her year-round first love is singing. Back home in Georgia, Kelly attends Westfield High School and works part-time as an assistant to her favorite dentist, who also just happens to be her father.
Now we want to give our special congratulations to all of our contestants. Now, two of our three areas of competition have been completed. Now, how are you doing at home as an armchair judge?
I'm at our computer station once again, ready to recap the judges' voting in the swimsuit competition. And I think here are the figures. Okay. First place goes to Miss Kentucky, second place to Miss Virginia, and third place to Miss California. Now remember, the audience here in the Lakeland Civic Center doesn't see these scores. Neither do the judges or the contestants. At this moment, you and I are the only ones who know how the panel of judges voted. Our evening gown competition is still ahead as the tension builds here at the Miss Teen USA pageant. We'll be right back after this word from Crest.
Look at our 10 semi-finalists. And a final chance for you at home and those of you in our audience here to make up your mind, because it's time now for our evening gown competition. Our setting is a summer evening dance. Each of our ladies is wearing an evening gown of her own choice. The escorts, the Florida Southern College Men's Ensemble. Air Supply sets the mood with the perfect song, Chances.
There's a chance you will be there. I'd like to know the truth. I'll find it out somehow. The chances aren't too strong. The chance you will be there. Please be there alone. Help me speak out loud. Chances are. Chances all there is.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Miss Teen USA evening gown competition. First, Miss Kentucky. Arkansas.
chance you will be there, wondering what to do. Everything good, everything fine, that's what you are. So put your hand in mine, and together we'll climb as high as the highest star.
My woman, a lifetime in every minute that we're together.
Miss Pennsylvania!
Computer station, the tabulated results of the voting will be seen almost immediately. And here they are. In first place, Miss Kentucky. In second place, Miss New York. And in third place, Miss Virginia. In a few more minutes, the field will be narrowed to only five finalists. Will your favorite be a winner? I hope so. We'll be back after a message from Ivory Liquid.
To thank every one of you to get up and take a bow, but I do want to acknowledge some very distinguished members of our audience. Mayor of St. Louis, Vincent Schemel. Now, you know, Lakeland is not only the citrus capital of the world, it also leads the nation in the production of phosphates. Into the mines to dig out the story. Thank you, Julie. Now, the announcement of the five finalists is coming up, but first, the finalists for the title of Miss Teen USA 1983. Now, let me remind you once again that the winner will be the very first Miss Teen USA, and the names of the five finalists are on this card. Again, I will read them in no particular order. Our first of the five finalists is Miss Virginia. Our second of the five finalists is from the state of New York. Our third finalist with a chance to be Miss Teen USA is from the state of Texas. Two more finalists, and one of them is Miss Georgia. And last, but certainly not least, Miss Kentucky. And there they are, the five finalists for the title of Miss Teen USA 1983.
There they are, the five very happy and very lovely young ladies who will vie for the honor of becoming the first Miss Teen USA. Was your favorite among them? Well, there you see the scores, but from here on in, no matter what the previous scores were, now all the girls start out even. Each of our semifinalists has an equal chance of winning. Right now, Michael has a question for our five finalists. Michael?
All right, now is our chance for the judges here and our audience and our audience at home to study the poise and intelligence of our five finalists. Now, I'm going to ask each contestant in turn the same question. Now, while waiting to be called on, the other young ladies will be in our booth back here, which is soundproof. So let's see, Miss Virginia, I'm going to start with you. If the other four ladies would please move back into the soundproof booth. All right, Miss Virginia, here's our question. What is there about teenagers you wish adults would better understand?
Peer pressure. Everybody's telling us not to do this because of peer pressure, not to do that because of peer pressure, and that we can handle it, that we can take care of ourselves.
Miss Virginia, thank you very much. If you would go back to our booth. And next we have Miss New York. All right, Miss New York, if you'd come right down here and join me, and we have a question for you. And our question is, what is there about teenagers that you wish adults would better understand?
Well, I wish that they would better understand that we really do appreciate all the little things they do for us, and that we are adolescents, so our tempers do flare up a little bit more than usual, and we're trying to control them. And even though we don't show the appreciation we should, we do love you all and appreciate you all.
Thank you, Miss New York. And next, we need Miss Texas. All right, Miss Texas, if you come right down here and join me, we have a question for you. Right here, please. All right, Miss Texas, what is there about teenagers that you wish adults would better understand?
I would wish they'd understand their more positive point of view, because sometimes when you look at a crowd of teenagers, one person will go out and do something wrong, and then everybody will focus in on that one bad person and say, well, all teenagers are bad. And I would wish that everybody would think that teenagers had a more positive point of view, that we do have ambitions in life, and we really are good people too.
Thank you, Miss Texas. You'll go right back up there, Miss Texas. And next we need Miss Georgia. Miss Georgia will come right down here and join us. All right, our question is, what is there about teenagers that you wish adults would better understand?
I believe that adults need to understand that teenagers are under a lot of strain by their peers. Peer pressure is one of the hardest things to live up to, and I believe that I know my parents understand, and I love them very much, and if they just give us a chance, that we'll make it.
Thank you, Miss Georgia. If you'd go right back up there and join the other girls. And we'll have Miss Kentucky come down here and join us. All right, Miss Kentucky, if you'd join me right here, we have a question for you. Here it is. What is there about teenagers that you wish adults would better understand?
Well, I think that if the adults and the teenagers would just get to know each other better, and I think that they would realize that they can learn from one another. And I think that if they would realize to give us a chance, that everyone can learn from one another.
Miss Kentucky, thank you very much. You go up and join the other girl. Now we're moving a little closer to finding out which of our five finalists is going to be the first, Miss Teen USA. Now, you know, during her reign, Miss Teen USA will be called upon for modeling assignments and photo sessions. And one of the qualities that she'll need is the ability to look relaxed in front of a camera. So with the help of the Solid Gold dancers as the photographers, we're going to hold sort of a little make-believe photo session. Now, as you're watching our finalists, the judges will be casting their votes and deciding who's going to be the fourth runner-up and, of course, who's going to be the winner. So it's picture-taking time when we all try to focus on the very first Miss Teen USA. I've seen your picture, your name in lights above it. This is your big debut. It's like a dream come true. So when you smile for the camera, I know they're gonna love it.
They're gonna love it. We'll take your picture. We'll put it on a cover. The world will look at you to see what you can do. Such a work of art. You're gonna take my heart. And when you smile for the camera, that smile is gonna shine, girl. I'm gonna shine. Girl, it will come back to you. Girl, it will come back to you. Shadow falls, you see it all on 3D.
for these five young women. I know how excited I would be if it were me standing there. But there are five finalists, and there can only be one Miss Teen USA. Our computer now has all the information it needs to tell us the winner. In just a minute, we'll see her crowned live after this message from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1983 Miss Teen USA.
The judges have made their decision. Holding the final computer tabulated results, listing four runners-up and our first Miss Teen USA. Now, these results have been reviewed by representatives of the international accounting firm of Ernst & Whinney. Now announce the fourth runner-up. Our fourth runner-up is Miss Texas. Runner-up is from the state of Georgia. Our second runner-up, Miss Kentucky. Now, the first runner-up is very important because should Miss Teen USA be unable to fulfill her reign for any reason, including being selected as the next Miss USA, the first runner-up will become Miss Teen USA. Now, I'm going to read the name of the first runner-up and then the name of Miss Teen USA. The first runner-up is Miss Virginia. Miss Teen USA is Miss New York, Ruth Zakarian. Winner to take her triumphant walk. Miss USA, Julie Hayek, will recite the Miss Teen USA creed. Go ahead, Ruth. And for the many press photographers who are here, take the pictures that we'll see in tomorrow's newspapers. Come on, photographers, it's picture taking time.
The United States and the Miss Teen USA pageant, in order to further the cause of peace, justice, and mutual understanding, we solemnly dedicate ourselves to the highest ideals of sportsmanship, friendship, and goodwill among all the people of the United States.
You see a very happy girl, Ruth Zakarian. Ruth, you want to step right over there, please? Can you get a few more pictures? Right over there, Ruth. Miss New York, Ruth Zakarian.
Everyone.